Hi everyone, as I told you the last time, again based on some figures and based on an episode from Initial D, I talked with my neighbor Marcel. He works for Volkswagen, he worked for Porsche, regarding why I feel that the Type R and the M3 are so similar and also so different, and that the cars felt unbelievably similar, driven to the limit. Although one is FF, the other one is FR. And he told me, you know, I had basically the same question. And he wondered why I always praise so much the Type R owning an M3, because this is hilarious, yes. And he told me he will show me a picture that he created himself. And look at this graph. So basically he took all the data that he had about the two cars and created an image. And when I saw this image, I told myself, okay, wow, if you see how wide the cars are, very similar. In the rear, how wide they are, almost identical. If you look at the weight, it's a huge difference. Power to weight ratio, of course the M3 has a lot better ratio, but there is not that a huge difference in my opinion. And if you look at the picture, the height of the two cars, almost identical, guys. Of course, the M3 is a lot longer. Ground clearance, very similar. 120 millimeters, 126 millimeters for the Type R. So if you look at this picture and you take in consideration that basically both these cars are set up also for track driving, you start to understand why they are also so similar, because the M4 competition has 730 on the Nordschleife, the Type R has 743, I believe. So there is a difference, of course, but there is not a huge difference. Or I don't know what you could consider huge on the Nordschleife. A Cayman GT4 has 730. So very similar to the M4 competition. But where the surprise comes is when you drive them very hard on a road with a lot of S-bends. And I've done that for 30-40 kilometers last weekend. And I did it a lot of times with the Type R there. I know the speeds from some corners. The revelation was that basically the two cars are extremely similar when driven to the absolute edge. Because the Type R, of course, is not FR, is FF, but it has a very well balanced lift-off oversteer. So this means that you could trigger the car to drift with the end in some scenarios, driving to some bends. And you always felt, and this is what I loved about the Type R, because it was the gearbox, the engine, and how the car turned. You felt every time when you push the car in a bend that the end is not, loose sounds stupid, but is a little bit helping you to keep that angle. Above 50-60 kilometers per hour with worn tires, I never felt a real issue, if the road is even, with the Type R. I never felt an issue that it's front wheel drive. With the M3, it's the same. If the tires are warm, if you are not punching on the pedal like crazy, so if you control what you are doing and you are driving the car near its grip limit, but you are not overdoing it, it's exactly the same feeling. You go in the turn and you feel that the car is coming, but not drifting. It's this closing the angle so that it helps you go in the S-band. On a public road, you can never push a car to the limit. But the feeling that I had with the Type R was that I've challenged a lot of times some band that I knew. 50, 52, 55, 58, 60, 62, I mean over time. And you wonder each time, man, it can handle more. And not the car is the limit, my driving skills are the limit. And this is the same feeling that I have with the M3. The feeling is, how the hell is the car not jumping off the street? But in the end, it was also a consideration that I had, how can it be that two basically different cars, FF, FR, completely different type of philosophy, feel so unbelievably similar, driven on the same road? And I believe it's the spirit of the car, because the M3 and the Type R are performance cars that are designed to be driven also, if you want, on a track. You can track them, both of them, as you can track a GT4. And I believe that the GT4 will be, after owning a Type R and the legendary Honda gearbox, an M3 with a legendary BMW gearbox, and now a Porsche gearbox, will be the culmination, because then I could compare FF, FR, and MR. So middle engine rear wheel drive. And that's why I'm so hyped now to buy this GT4, because you have the engine inside the car, you have the best possible layout so that you can push the car. It's perfectly even. Weight distribution is as good as it gets. I hope I managed to explain you my surprise when understanding that these two cars that are so differently basically are not that different at all. And I know we have here somebody, Mike, who had a Type R and has an M3. Maybe Mike, if you see this video, you can comment if you have the same feeling, if you had the occasion to drive the car really spirited on the same road that you know well, and you had the same feeling that I had or have, that they are so evenly matched in some scenarios. See you guys.